Hey fall adventurers, welcome back to my channel. My name is Erica and today we're going to Grand Haven. So me and my fiance Josh and our dog Smokey and Max, we live in the Grand Rapids area. And oh, hi Max. Hi. And we have not been to Grand Haven yet. So we thought today it would be fun to go explore Grand Haven, go down by the beach and maybe go downtown and get something to eat. So that's what we're gonna be doing today. So I hope you guys are excited to come along. Okay, so right now I'm just deciding what to wear. So we live a little bit more inland from Lake Michigan, so it's gonna be, I think, a high of 50 degrees today, but I know it's gonna be colder closer to the lake. So right now I have on like leggings and this like Northern Michigan sweatshirt with this puffer jacket that's actually Josh's, kind of stole from him. But I'm just worried because it's kind of navy blue, and aren't you not supposed to mix navy blue and black? I don't know, but I kind of like it. I think it's cute. Maybe if I wore like a hat, that might be cute. So I want to take some pictures when we're down by the beach, but I think this is going to be the outfit for today. I mean, it's not that bad, right? It's not clashing too bad. I think it looks good. Okay, so before we go, I definitely want to pack waters and snacks. We're going to leave. Okay, it's about 11:30 right now, and I think we're going to get lunch down there, or like late lunch, early dinner. But I still want to bring snacks, tons of water for both us and the dogs. Maybe some dog food just in case we're too late and they're hungry for dinner. So that's what I'm gonna pack right now. So I have three waters and I'm gonna make a fourth. And then I made some banana muffins the other night. So then I'm gonna bring those and chips, snacks, bananas, just that kind of stuff. So let's go ahead and pack up. So I think we're all packed up to go. So in the bag that Max is sniffing, that is all the food. We packed some of their dog food too, just in case we didn't make it home in time for their dinner time. Have four bottles of water for the four of us. And then in this bag, we just have extra hats and gloves, a hairbrush, my wallet, keys, just in case we get cold and all the stuff we need. But yeah, you guys ready to go bye-bye? You ready to go bye-bye in the car? Yeah. Oh, and then we're definitely gonna bring like a dog towel in case they get dirty, because that would not be fun if they got the car all dirty. But yeah, I think we're ready to rock and roll and go to Grand Haven. You ready, Maxie? Yeah. All right, so we are all packed up in the car heading to Grand Haven. It actually says, I thought it was gonna take us an hour to get there. It might only take us like 45 minutes, so that's awesome. And I was just looking up like things to do in Grand Haven, so I was looking up on Pure Michigan website. So for those of you who've never been to Grand Haven like myself, here's like a little snippet about the place. So Grand Haven area is famous for its soft sand beaches, picturesque lighthouse, which I have seen that lighthouse. It's like a really pretty red lighthouse. I hope that we could walk out to it. I don't know if like it's covered in ice, like the pier or whatever, but I hope we can see that. And then I know they're also famous, it says, for their musical fountain, which plays nightly from Memorial Day through Labor Day. So if you're coming in the summer, probably check that out. We're in March right now, so that's definitely not playing. But yeah, so Grand Haven is obviously on the west side of Michigan because we live on the west side. And it's a little bit north of Holland. So I'll put like a picture of the map right here so you guys can kind of see. But yeah, I think we just put in Grand Haven in our GPS and we're just gonna see what it's all about, see when we get there. I definitely wanna walk like the shoreline if we can, and probably grab a bite to eat. So I'm gonna look up some restaurants here, but yeah, we'll be there pretty soon.
We just entered Grand Haven. What is it called? City limits? I don't know. There was a sign that said welcome to Grand Haven, so we're here. We're gonna drive to the state park that's on the water, but yeah, this is kind of in town, I guess. I don't think we're like in the downtown area yet, but yeah, we've made it though. Now we just turned right and we're about 5 minutes from the state park. So I just thought I'd show you guys kind of the vibes around here. Some cute little houses. So there's definitely a lot of like, looks like new developments here. These kind of look like apartment buildings. go kind of far back, so it's nice. Oh, okay, what's this up here? Grand Haven Musical Fountain. So that's over there, I guess. In the summer, you can go watch the music fountain. Oh, this looks like the downtown over there. It's cute. Yeah, it comparing it to Holland, I would say, oh yeah, downtown shopping and dining that way. So we'll head that way after we go to the beach. But first impressions, yeah, I really like it. I think it's cute. I think it looks a little bit newer than Holland, would you say that?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. All right, we are almost to the state park. I see the lighthouse like way out there. Excuse my finger, but there's a ton of people out here walking right now. You can like walk all along here. And also just keep in mind it is March, so things are still kind of dead around here, like the trees and the grass. I'm sure it's really pretty here in the summer. Yeah, so I think we're gonna get out and park at the state park and walk around now. Is this the state park right here? Oh, that's a connector park, but same thing. We can just park here and start walking. Oh, maybe this is the state park. Oh yeah, Grand Haven State Park Channel parking lot. Oh, the dogs are getting really excited. Where are we, guys? So we parked over there and then we're just walking towards the beach right now. Looks like there's lots of like restrooms and a playground. And then the lighthouse is over that sand dune. So we're gonna try and walk out there. Okay, so we're just walking to the beach and I noticed, what is that, just electricity outlet?
Yeah.
So I think that these are camping spots. So in the summer, this is where you can camp and then you can literally camp right on the beach, I'm guessing. That's so cool, but also that'd be so much sand you'd probably track into your camper tent. But huh, I've never seen a campground that was like literally right on the beach. That's so cool. Also, I'm guessing that in the summertime dogs can't come on the beach because of, you know, bathroom situations, but since it's winter right now, I think it's kind of a free-for-all. No one really cares. But we've made it to Lake Michigan and there's a lighthouse. It's so pretty. So the lake obviously is not frozen right now, but we were just talking about some of the people that do the polar plunge. I don't know if I could ever do that. That's really cold, but let me know down in the comments. Would you ever do a polar plunge? Also, if you don't know what that is, it's basically like going and jumping into a lake in like the middle of winter where it's absolutely freezing. So let me know. Probably not for me, but people do it. So there's the beach that we walked, but if you're not into walking the beach, there's this path that goes like all the way over there, kind of towards downtown. So that's nice too, a little paved walkway. All right, we have completed our walk. The dogs are pretty tired now. So we walked all along the beach and then we walked to the pier and back. And I think we're gonna go get something to eat. I think we're gonna try out this restaurant called the Toasted Pickle. Is that what it said when you pulled it up? And it's right downtown, so they have like, looks like pretty good sandwiches. And maybe pop into a few shops, but yeah, that is what we're doing next. So let's go eat. right, guys, we just finished up lunch. Yeah, lunch, it's 3 o'clock. And we ate at the Toasted Pickle in downtown Grand Haven, and it was so good. It was like a really cute little cafe. So you walk in and you order like at the counter, and then you can just pick whatever table and they'll bring the food to you. So I got, I think it was called the Green Goddess Grilled Cheese. Said it was featured on Food Network, so that's kind of why I was like, all right, well, must be good. And it was really good. It was grilled cheese with avocado and pesto sauce, I think. And they gave me like a little cup of tomato soup to dip it in. And then Josh got, what did you get?
The Nashville hot.
You had two huge slices of chicken on it, though.
Yeah, it was two chicken patties.
Yeah.
The sauce was like kind of like a honey mustard. Mm. It was really heavy on the honey, which was kind of interesting, but it was pretty good.
Okay. And then we got a side of truffle fries as well. But it says that they're known for milkshakes and freshly squeezed lemonade, but we just didn't get that today. But we really, really liked it. Like, definitely would eat there again. That was so good. And then we didn't really go into any shops. I filmed a little bit of the outside of them. They were just kind of like cute, typical little downtown shops, but we're kind of getting tired now, so we're gonna head home. But overall, I really like Grand Haven, like a lot. And again, we were here in winter, springtime. And I think coming down here in the summer would be so amazing. Like that, the fountain show that they do every night. And I mean, the beach was gorgeous. It's really, really nice here. Like I think I would say it's, yeah, like clean cut, nice, like very family friendly. Yeah, so we really, really liked it. I hope you guys enjoyed this little vlog of our little, not staycation, but just like a little getaway. To the beach. And yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed, and if you do, please give this video a big thumbs up and go ahead and hit that subscribe button so you don't miss out on any of my future adventures. So that is all for today. Bye, guys.
Bye. You got me loose and set me free.